Hey all, I'm back again with yet another exciting video. One of the most common adopted cloud migration strategies to lift and shift applications from on-premise, but also to exploit the elasticity, nimbleness and agility that is required to release new features to the market faster, cheaper and smarter. And that's what cloud native applications do. But how can we migrate a large landscape of brownfield VM-based applications to containers running on a platform like Kubernetes? Let's find it today with an awesome tool on Google Cloud called Migrate for Anthos. I'm Raju Pillai, and I'm a customer engineer with Google Cloud, and I specialize in application modernization. And I work on technologies like Kubernetes and related in a hybrid and multi-cloud.
So whenever I ask this question to a customer that what is a modern apps according to them, I get different answers. So it's important to define what we think a modern application are. So it's normally deployed as a microservices architecture in a containerized form factor. Containers are a small unit of work which typically run on a cloud native platform like Kubernetes and basically benefit from the elasticity of that platform. Some customers also adopt serverless technology that gives them the benefit of scale to zero, pay as you go, and when required, scale to a planned size. Oftentimes, it's combined with a continuous integration and a continuous delivery process with the best practices of DevOps that the different teams adopt. We also see that some customers use service meshes to very effectively monitor and observe and manage their microservices. Also, API management is an important aspect whenever you want to, expose your services to an external world for monetization process or for just building more complex applications. Oftentimes, it's all deployed on an open source heavy environment. There are different maturity models for the cloud. The one which is very prevalent in the industry is this particular model, in which there are these four different levels of maturity. Cloud ready is where you have moved your applications to the cloud. It uses some of the managed services offered by the cloud and is generally self-contained and uses some of the platform services. The cloud friendly is where you actually have looked into your application, probably try to improve them by applying the 12-factor principles. It can be horizontally scaled, and that's when the elasticity of the cloud can be leveraged. The next is the cloud resilient one. Now this is interesting because you start to practice some of the site reliability engineering practices of a fault tolerant system with possibly less amount of failures, and you effectively use the operations tools, metrics and logs to create something called as service level objectives that helps you define your SLAs. And the finest level is the cloud native level, which I think some of the attributes we talked about. So the idea is to basically move to this cloud native maturity model. Teams who really practice this, we have seen, or we call them as elite teams, they're able to release into production so often as multiple times in a day and with confidence. So that's the idea, that you want to basically have zero downtime releases. Applications so that we can find the right migration approach for it. Generally, it is called as application portfolio analysis. Broadly put together, there are different categories. So the first one is a greenfield application, which are applications in flight. Some of them already imbibe the modern application principles that we talked about, and they may have touch points that varies from mobile to web app to chatbots. Some of them may even be Kubernetes apps or Kube apps. Nowadays the user generated content are so much, streaming systems are also good examples of this. These applications are normally written using lightweight JavaScript frameworks like Angular, Node or React, or on the Java side it may be with the popular Spring Boot applications, which are already a very good candidate for microservices. Also on the Windows side of things, may have been written using the .NET Core, which is a cross-platform framework to writing new .NET applications. Some of these applications may already have the deployment descriptors like Helm chart or YAML files. And these, because of the nature of applications and the type of customers it serves, which is B2C,
they're pretty complex sometimes, right? They also have a very high value because sometimes the businesses itself are based on those applications. And because of which, these applications require frequent updates and releases to production. So a very good fitment for these applications can be our serverless environment called Cloud Run. Very good for APIs and also for web and mobile applications. But if you have some state associated with it, then a GKE standard or a GKE autopilot can be a great option. The second bucket is those systems written 5-10 years back, you know, when SOA and ESP were popular, transactional systems, web applications, portals, content management systems, web experience management systems, and ETL jobs. So these are applications either written in a .NET framework or written in a J2E environment, typically deployed with some of the SOA and ESP concepts using middlewares like WebLogic, WebSphere, Tomcat, or JBoss. So these applications are also quite complex, but along with serving the B2C customers, we have seen that a lot of deployment of these things are for the internal IT applications, for the what we call as a custom development in-house. So these applications are also complex and have stateful routing and load balances in place. So a good fitment for this can be the GKE or both on-premise or on the cloud. The third bucket is the core systems of record, the SAPs, the ERPs, the MDMs, HRMS systems, the Siebel systems, the Microsoft Dynamics, those you know, core applications, some of the databases like Oracle DB or SQL, non-Linux or non-x86, Unixes, like, you know, IBM or Solaris. So some of these applications are hard to migrate to the cloud or cloud native environment, but definitely possible to move to cloud. And a good fitment for this can be a Google Compute Engine, or if you're looking for bring your own licenses, then Sultanint may be a good option.
Thank you for watching this video, but please stay tuned for the second part of the series. In part B, I'm going to actually do a live migration of a VM app from the portfolio that we have just discussed into a Kubernetes environment using Migrate4Enterprise. We will also discuss about the limitations as well as the challenges and what benefits do you get by not breaking open your application, but instead just containerizing your application, running in a cloud environment.